Aloha, Martina Wing here, live from Hawaii. Talking about manta rays again, my true love. These are such beautiful creatures. And I'm a manta lover and ocean advocate, educator, and I live here in Kona, Hawaii. And today I wanted to talk to you guys about the diet of a manta ray and what they eat. And you will be surprised about the numbers, what they actually consume every week. And so let's just jump right into this. First of all, where are we located? We are on the big island. Like this way? That's right, yeah. So we are on the big island of Hawaii. So we're talking about manta rays that I enjoy here along the Kona coast. And we have locations where by the airport and Keaho where manta rays show up on a very regular basis. And that is where I all got my footage that I will show you here in a few minutes. I have, again, props set up for you so you understand everything a little bit better. Visuals are definitely a good thing for me. And so manta rays feed on plankton. That's really much what it is. And I have, I'm going to turn the screen real quick so you can actually see what I'm talking about. And I have some videos prepared for you guys as well. So let's see what's happening. Let me push the button. There we go. Okay, so yeah, this is what you're talking about. How much manta rays do manta rays eat? So let me go into the first screen I have here. Here we go. And Tara is back here. So thank you so much for being here, Tara. One of my true fans. Thank you so much for that. What do manta rays eat? Well, I had to go to Wikipedia. That's so much easier to figure that out. But it is called any drifting organism, animal, plants, archaea, or bacteria that inhabit the pelagic zone of oceans, seas, and bodies of fresh water. So this is what Wikipedia says about plankton. I'm not going to dispute that in any way because I don't know much about this real particular about plankton. There's a lot of studies and there's a really interesting number. It's about 5,000 different species of plankton are drifting in the ocean, in the oceans, in the water. And that's a lot of different animals or different creatures, excuse me, because they're also plants. A little easier definition for plankton would be anything that cannot swim against the current. And that's what manta rays feed on. And so I want to show you the next picture, how it looks like, what manta rays are really looking for. So what you see on this picture is, this is a dive light down here. So you see the light from a dive light, we place it underwater. And when you do it at night, the plankton is drawn to this particular light. And you see all these little critters. It's like an alphabet soup of these 5,000 species, I guess. But I do understand that manta rays prefer a certain kind. Coco pod is one of them. We have nights where the plankton is not very abundant or it's really little small red dots, hard to describe, but they don't look like white, bigger pieces. And the manta rays don't like the little ones. They actually like this kind. That's how it looks like that they feed on. And to give you an idea how manta rays feed, quick recap. I've done this on a different Facebook Live with the anatomy. You can check that out too. Here we go to the mouth. So this is the mouth of a manta ray. Yeah, so when a manta ray feeds, it actually, the water goes into their mouth and with the plankton as well. The plankton is raked out by the gill rakers. That's the black big pieces here. And then here, that's the gill arch to keep the cavity open. And the manta rays rake the plankton to the back of their mouth where esophagus sits. And then behind the gill rakers are the gills, and that's where the water goes through. And then they take the oxygen. And then this is the underside of a manta ray. So here you see the gill slits. That's where the water comes back out. Just from it's a very simple filter system, but this is what they're looking for. They want this stuff here all the time. Alrighty. So let me see real quick what my next picture was. And here's a short video for you guys so you can have actually imagine how this works. This is Vinnie Ray. And now this is a night where the manta ray, the plankton was so abundant. It was crazy. It was so abundant. And this just happened after 10, 15 minutes. So much plankton was in the area accumulating and the manta ray just had a feast on feeding and enjoying so much food. And you see some fish here on the side too. They come into the situation as well. They want the plankton. So many other creatures take advantage of that as well. Oops, sorry about that. Here you go, one more time. Vinnie Ray enjoying a feast of plankton. Yeah. And then usually people ask us how much plankton do manta rays eat. I do have a little bit of a math for you guys. Let's see. I made a slide. And I hope you go with me on this one. It is really fun. So how much do manta rays actually eat in plankton? So the number is that I learned over the years, I cannot really prove it, but this is what the experts say. 12% of their body weight is what the manta ray looks for in plankton per week. So as an example, I want to give you the a 10-foot manta ray. It's the easiest way to put this together. But we estimate that every foot of a manta ray is about 100 pounds. That would mean a 10-foot manta ray is a 1,000-pound creature. Now, when we take 12% of 1,000, that would be 120 pounds of plankton. Wow. So, and then Kara Osada, Darvella, did a study a few years ago, at least 12, 13 years ago, here in town, during the manta ray dive. She put out nets and she wanted to figure out where the plankton is at what time of the month with the moon phases and what the manta rays prefer to eat. So really interesting study. And I probably put into the comment section a link to her work. But she came up with this really interesting number of that 10,000 pieces of plankton equals one dry ounce. So one dry ounce, 10,000 pieces of plankton. Now, if you, the 16 ounces are 1 pound, had to look that up, I think metric. I'm sorry, this is not really easy for me, this calculation. But if you go by 120 pounds of plankton, how many pieces of plankton that equals? We are at 19,200,000 pieces of plankton that the manta ray looks for every week if he's about 10 foot wingspan. I think this is a real wow number, how much manta rays have to eat. But, you know, going back to this, the manta ray just has a big mouth in the front. It's definitely for this reason that they need so much food. The mouth is just so big compared to their body. All right. So then another question that people give us, ask us all the time is, why is this not happening to me? Hold on a second, guys. Why is this all selecting? Because I'm sitting on it. Do manta rays actually eat fish as well? I get that question all the time from people. And I have some footage for you guys where I can show you if manta rays get a fish into their mouth, what actually happens. And in this case, this is Kara Ray enjoying the food in front of snorkelers. In itself, this is already pretty fun footage. But I want to show you when a fireworm gets into Kara's mouth. Okay, I'm going to go back a little bit to show you that again. It's really fast. But there's a fireworm. It's like a caterpillar. Do you see him right here? And then Kara gets it into its mouth. And you see how she pushes it back out. This is just crazy. So this creature is just too big for her. She doesn't want it. For sure doesn't want it. And in and back out. So this is just a good example how manta rays do not like to have anything else into their mouth other than plankton. And then I have another video for you guys, which is really fun, where we had a jellyfish on the reef. Now this is a situation where when these big jellies come on the reef, they usually die. We don't see them very close on the reef. They are on their last leg. And so I was just enjoying myself filming it. I'm going to skip forward a little bit where I have Captain Zane come into the picture. We just thought this cool video, him in the background and stuff like this. But what we actually did at that time, we had so much light on. See, Zane had light on and I had my lights on. We got a lot of plankton going. Let me just skip forward a little bit. And then Valerie wanted that plankton. And she's coming into the picture here any second. Just enjoy the footage until then. But here you go. You see all the little plankton? It's kind of cool. And then Valerie's like, oh, I want the plankton. She doesn't even know there's a jellyfish right in front of her. Now check this out. Into her mouth, and immediately it came back out of her mouth. I'm going to replay that two more times because it's so cool. I've seen it so many times and I still enjoy this. Check this out. in her mouth, out of her mouth. I love this. And one more time. Into the mouth and out of her mouth. Yeah, and the jelly just really went for a roller coaster right there. Valerie took off. I don't think she liked it very much anymore. And the jellyfish just hung out on the reef and was probably then dying. Anyway, so this is what I wanted to show you guys from my footage. I'm going to turn you around. You're back with me. I hope you enjoyed this a little bit. It's a little shorter Facebook Live today. It's all about what the manta rays eat and how much they eat. I hope you enjoy this. So if you do, just hit like, give me a share, leave a comment. I love to be social on social media. And then I will see you next week on Wednesday, 11 a.m. and tell you more about the manta rays that I love so much here on the Kona Coast. And I want to share my knowledge and my passion with you for those. Thank you so much and talk to you later. Bye.